experience. Well, came up just short in his dream of making it to the Olympics. Could he realize his dream of winning $1 million? If there was a time for his rock climbing experience to help him out, it'd be on this upper body intensive stage 2 course. He was a world-ranked speed climber, so you know he just wants to get a shot on stage 4, because I don't know that anybody can keep up with him on a rope.
Until you put Josh Levin on stage 4, oh, he's got it.
Just needs to get through this course tonight, then take on stage 3, which should really play to his strengths.
No mistakes. Look at that. Look at his rock climbing technique. Look how strong he is. This dude can climb for days. He's a speed climber, a rock climber, and a ninja.
And just look at his core strength as he moves through these pistons. This dude is ripped.
Look at those muscles.
Is that what all the engineers who went to Harvard look like? Oh, no, I don't think so.
He's got friends and supporters all along the rails watching. They know that finishing stage 2 would mean to Josh Levin. And he gets a piston punch.
But hammer drop is a wild card. It's so hard to practice for this.
5, 6, 150.
Ooh, using those arms and legs like a vice grip. He needs to wrap around and get on top of the cylinder. Well, with that engineering degree, you know he understands the angles. This dude always has a plan, and he understands physics, believe me.
He did not hesitate. Just stood up and jumped. He's talked about being Josh 2.0. More aggressive and taking chances, and he is living up to it.
And now he's 2 obstacles away from that first stage 2 buzzer. Up next, the Hornet's Nest, and this has been trouble. Ended the seasons of 5 dangers tonight. Josh working through his moves. Shaking it out. Once you are up, those forearms get no rest. And wow, just crisply locking those honeycombs into place. Trying to be our 10th finisher tonight on stage 2.
Nice! In past seasons, this is about where he would fall on this 5th obstacle. That's going to beat his mind right now.
He wants to conquer stage 2 so badly.
Watch this. This is a great angle to see that 10-foot lache. And sideways, too, and to have to make the adjustment and turn in mid-air. Look at that. Perfect. It's not easy.
Now watch those hips. You want to make sure those hips go right parallel.
This is a multi-directional obstacle. Twisting and turning.
Got it. Just needs the dismount. Can he hang on? His heart's got to be pounding.
Got it! Levitating in the air.
One step closer to going to stage 3. But this is the falling shelves with the blind grab that's ended the season of so many ninjas in the past.
He's visualizing his moves. He knows he's so close.
Takes a deep breath. Here we go. Clock ticking down.
All right, watch this one. Yeah,
look at the efficiency here.
We got some cheese going to stage 3. And this is an OG.
But this is it, the blind grab.
There's a lot of blind grab in rock climbing, so he's used to it. Look at him, he's locked in, down. And
got it! 10 seconds!
He's good.
Josh Levin! He's done it!
He broke the buzzer!
And you can see the joy!
He broke the buzzer and broke the streak!
Emotional.
He just ran off the stage.
Oh,
he's going nuts.
Well, that run right there, that might have just won him $1 million.
Stage 2 was the one mountain this top climber hadn't conquered. But he made all the right moves, including on falling shells. And he was so excited, he broke the buzzer.
Oh, look at this. Real emotion.
Wow, that meant so much to him.
And now you gotta think, he's gonna be tough to beat for that $1 million.
Well, that does it for tonight. Next week, we move on to our season finale.
And Matt, these ninjas look so strong, I think one of them is gonna take home a $1 million prize next week.
Don't wanna miss it. Brock Barbaja, Mia Miller, and Terry Hall, I'm Matt Eisman. We'll see you then on American Ninja Warrior.